Hey, what's going on, fellas? How we doing? Matt Antonelli here. Today, going over some infield drills that we do with all of our players. Today, we're going to talk about the ball in hand or ball in glove drill. So this is a drill we're going to use before we get into live fungos and then obviously the game. What we do is we set a bucket up right here in the infield. We'll have a line of a couple players, three, four players. Every player is going to grab a ball, put it in their glove. And what we're going to do is we're going to work through every possible ball that we could get in a game. Okay, so we're going to work on the routine ground ball right at us. We're going to work on balls to our right where we got to just get around the ball. We're going to work on inside the body backhands, which are those balls that are hit kind of out there where we can't get around them. So we're just going to come over, turn our glove over, feel it and throw. We'll go extended backhands where we're over here, ball that we've got to really get going for, feel the ball extended, throw. We'll go for that same ball in here where the runner's a little slower and we have time to kind of get around it, feel it here, set our feet and throw. We'll work on balls to our left, where we've got to cut the angle with our left foot, field it and throw. Extended balls over here, where we're going to field the ball here and turn and throw this way. Or maybe if the ball kind of gets past our body and we catch the ball behind us, we use the momentum of the ball to turn, throw to first. We can do slow rollers. We can go double play feeds, where we underhand flip. Balls to our right, where we're going to throw uphill. Backhand balls. You can do any position. So this is a great drill to be able to get a ton of reps in and really work on the footwork, really concentrate and break down the footwork of every single play that you could possibly make. When I was with the Washington Nationals, we did this drill every single morning in spring training. So you'd go out to the field early in the morning, there'd be buckets set up at every position, and you'd go over, you'd grab the ball, the coach would sit there and start saying, okay, routine ball right at us, ball just to our right. And we'd cover all of these different plays. This is where I got this drill from. It was the first time I saw anyone put a ball in their glove and just work through the play, boom, and make the throw. And I was like, this is interesting. First one I saw, I go, well, this is kind of easy. But then as I started doing it, I started realizing, well, if I'm able to learn the footwork on every play that I could possibly make, now once the ball's hit to me and I have to make that play, I've done it 100,000 times before. My feet just happen to work. And so it's really, really important, especially for young kids. A lot of kids see this drill and they go, ah, that drill's kind of easy. Like, what are we doing here? Like any drill, you got to coach it and make sure they're doing it correctly. But it's an awesome way to cover every single ground ball, make sure that we're doing the footwork perfectly. You've got to do the footwork the right way. Every play requires different footwork. And so when you teach the player the footwork on all the plays, I'm telling you, once the ball starts being hit, the player goes to get it and says, I've done this before. I've been here before. Boom. Easy. Footwork gets improved so much quicker. You can get tons of reps in really, really fast. You can have a bunch of players going at the same time. You don't need a lot of fungo guys. You don't need any fungo guys for this drill, okay? It's just a really good way to start the day off and then progress to fungos. So again, you're just gonna take the ball, you're gonna put the ball right there in your glove, and you're gonna go through every play, all right? The other really cool thing about this, I get emails and messages all the time from players saying, how do I work on my infield? I don't have someone to hit me a ground ball. I don't have somebody every day to hit balls to me or roll balls to me. Well, in this drill, all you need is one baseball and you. That's it. You don't need anyone to hit you ground balls. And so you can go out in the backyard and you can go through 100, 200, 500, 1,000 reps, however long you want to stay out there. You can cover every single play. And if you don't have a fungo hitter for that day or someone to throw you the ball, and you don't even need someone to catch you the ball, just have a target, right? Or just envision a first baseman over there. You can go through double plays, every ground ball that you could possibly get. You can get a ton of work in when other people aren't willing to do this, right? And so there are no excuses. I always say there's no excuses. You can find a way to do things. This is just another way. You can go through a ton of reps. Okay, we talk about how to work on your hands, get a racquetball, tennis ball, get off a wall and just bounce it off and do all the drills that we talk about. So you can find ways to do it. This is a really, really cool way to get tons of reps in, really work on your footwork. I know it'll make you better. I've done it a ton and it really, really helped me as an older player. I was 26, 27 years old doing this drill. So if you're 12 or 13, you can't say, well, that's a little league drill. It's not. I've seen major league players do it. Okay, so let me know if you have any questions in the comment section below. I appreciate you guys checking out the video. Please subscribe to the channel if you've not done so already. Share it with all your friends. Give us a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate that also. Check out our Instagram, Antonelli Baseball, and our Twitter feed, Matt Antonelli 9. We're posting videos all the time for you guys to help you get better. And that's all I got. Thanks again, guys. I appreciate it, and we'll talk to you later.